Hello everyone, and welcome to KCOMBA's webinar about the impact of the environmental protection policies and the ongoing trade dispute between China and the USA on the pesticides industry in China. This presentation will serve as a guideline for investments and give insights in the development in this highly promising sector in China. I am Patrick, and I am very happy to guide you through today's webinar. At the beginning, first have a look at the agenda of the presentation today. I start with an introduction of China's pesticides market. After this, we continue with the effect of environmental protection measurements on the market. The next part covers the pressure from policies in China. We will then analyze the reaction of Chinese buyers and the influence on Chinese pesticides exports. The presentation ends with the outline of the Sino-US trade war influence. So just for your information, the data analysis and information for this webinar comes from CCM and Trendanalysis, which are the market and trade intelligence brands under KCOMBA. So if you need additional and detailed reports on the topic discussed today, please have a look on the following reports, like Import of Environmental Policies on Pesticides in China, or Crops and Pesticide Market in the Sino-US Trade War. Or contact our sales team or your account manager directly to see all the research that KCOMBA can provide. So, China exports pesticides to over 160 countries and regions all over the world. According to the General Administration of Customs of China, the export volume of pesticides increased to 1.4 million tons by 2016, and herbicides kept the dominant role with a share of 68.9% in terms of volume. According to the data from the NBS, the output of China's pesticide technical continued to decline in the beginning of 2018. According to the performances of most agrochemical companies that have announced their performances in 2017, their operating incomes increased substantially year on year. These companies saw relatively large growth in domestic operating incomes and profits, and the weakened price advantages in the international market. Agrochemical companies faced with different degrees of selling pressures in the foreign trade. China has considerably increased environmental improvement measurements in recent years, written down in the state's Sustainable Development Strategy. The whole country is affected by constant inspections and forced production limitations, which is significantly reducing the supply of China's manufacturers, especially the ones in heavy polluting industries such as agrochemicals. According to market intelligence firm CCM, the new environmental protection policies in China, they will successfully have significant influence on the country's pesticide industry. The Chinese government is now actively strengthening the pesticide industry by releasing stricter policies for environmental protection, raising threshold, phasing out highly toxic and also highly residual pesticides. So, what are the impact on the environmental protection measurements? Let's have a look at the impact on output of pesticides. The impact of environmental protection policies on China's domestic pesticide production is mainly reflected in the output of pesticides. In 2017, China stepped up the implementation of environmental protection policies. Many agrochemical companies restricted production or relocated production lines and even temporarily suspended production, and also shutdowns were witnessed. The country's pesticide industry saw low operating rate, declined pesticide output and tight supply. In retrospect to the pesticide market in 2017, it can be found that the high environmental protection pressure was one of the main factors affecting the development of China's pesticide industry. China's introduction of a series of environmental protection policies has equipped the law enforcement of environmental issues with mandatory legal instruments. Under the influence of high environmental pressure, the operating rate of the pesticide industry in China decreased, leading to a shrinking output. In 2017, China's total output of pesticide technical was less than 3 million tons, declining by about 8.7% year on year. From the perspective of current environmental protection policies, the situation of strict protection will continue in the short term. What's more, pesticide manufacturers and local management departments have accumulated certain experience in 2017 and have made some corresponding adjustments. When it comes to the pesticide industry, despite the high requirements for environmental pollution due to the large number of wastes, including water, gas, and solid waste, some pesticide enterprises in China seek profits before safety and therefore fail to spend on necessary environmental protection investments. These deliberate disobey of environmental protection laws and regulations are endangering the sustainable development of this very important industry in China. After all, China's government is conducting environmental protection measurements throughout the country since 2015, which is restricting the supply of raw materials ever since. The announcement of further pollution inspections in 2018 and 2019 is supporting a tight supply of Chinese raw materials, which often serve as the main intermediate for the pesticide production. Under the strict environmental protection policies, there are opportunities for relatively strong pesticide companies. In the pesticides market, where prices have risen sharply in 2017, they have achieved growth in operating revenue as well as profits through environmental protection reforms, technology upgrades, and effective cost control. What's more, as enterprises which fail to meet the environmental standards will gain more market share, for small plants, environmental protection policies bring even more challenges. In recent years, as various laws and regulations related to environmental protection have been introduced in succession, pesticides companies have found themselves under increasing pressure. In 2017, local governments in China had stepped up the implementation of environmental laws and regulations. Especially in the second half of 2017, pesticide companies obviously felt the pressure from environmental protection policies in terms of raw material costs and environmental protection costs. Inevitably, many pesticide companies have restricted production, relocated, or even shut down, causing a continuous decline in pesticide output and further led to tight supply and therefore increasing pesticide prices. Under such circumstances, traders and manufacturers have raised the price of pesticide technical, causing the price of most pesticides to keep rising. Therefore, China's exports of pesticides lost their price advantages internationally to some extent. Under the environmental protection pressure, many pesticides were in short supply in 2017 and the prices continued to rise. In 2017, most of the major agrochemical producers in China achieved increases in operating income and profit. The overall operating revenue and operating profit of China's pesticide industry increased by 8% and 25% year on year, respectively. Besides, in 2017, pesticide suppliers' speculation on pesticide prices played a non-negligible role in driving up pesticide prices. Differences between quoted prices and transaction prices of pesticides in the second half of 2017 were much higher than in the first half of 2017, owing to the fact that manufacturers and traders took the opportunity to raise their prices. China's environmental protection policies affect China's pesticide exports, mainly in terms of export volume and prices. Under the severe environmental protection policies, manufacturers of China's pesticide and its raw material are restricted in production. In the case of declining output, the domestic market has experienced a tight supply of pesticide, leading to the rising export prices of pesticides and also their main raw materials. So, the export prices of pesticides have inevitably risen accordingly. Let's have a look at the pressure from policies in China. In 2017, the national new policies and regulations on environmental protection emerged frequently. Specifically, there were normalization of environmental protection inspections by the central government as well as local governments, high pressure environmental protection supervision, and wide-ranging environmental protection storms. The entire agrochemical industry is facing unprecedented pressure. Hence, it's a challenging time for Chinese pesticide traders and formulation manufacturers. They are caught in the middle of the pesticide value chain, under pressure from price increases and supply shortage from pesticide technical manufacturers and raw material producers. The traders also worry that orders from retailers and downstream companies will be reduced due to the escalating prices, which will cause a backlog of the goods. Therefore, these traders and pesticide formulation manufacturers had always shown a wait-and-see attitude towards the industry and cautious attitude towards procurement in 2017. In 2018, it is expected that this kind of wait-and-see behavior and cautious procurement will continue along with the increasing impact of further policies. As we discussed, the price of most pesticides rose in 2017. Compared with the same period of previous years, some pesticide technical have even increased by more than 100% and became the highly sought products. The relationship between pesticide technical enterprises and formulation ones has become subtler. In the case of tight supply of pesticides, the selling pressure on pesticide technical enterprises was reduced and they got more initiative. Relatively speaking, the pesticide formulation enterprises as purchasers were under larger pressures correspondingly and they became relatively passive. In 2018, the previous environmental protection policies and measures have continued to affect China's pesticide industry. Notably, two more policies and measures on environmental protection began to take effect at the beginning of 2018, namely the Environmental Protection Tax Law of the People's Republic of China and the Measures for Pollutant Discharge Permitting Administration. Therefore, the pressure on pesticide supply is intensified, according to CCM's analysis. It is expected that the output of China's pesticide technical will continue to decline in 2018, maybe falling below 2.8 million tons. Previously, the pesticide manufacturing industry companies needed to apply for pollutant discharge permits, 2017 and before. Only after obtaining pollutant discharge permits, companies can discharge water waste and exhaust gas and produce normally. The companies failing to obtain pollutant discharge permits may withdraw from the market in the near future. Let's have a look at the reaction of Chinese buyers generally. The influence of the price increase of pesticides in 2017 was more reflected in the level of dealers and traders of pesticide technical and pesticide formulation enterprises. Traders and formulation enterprises are the main buyers in the industry, but most of them showed a wait-and-see attitude. Faced with the skyrocketing price of pesticides and the major materials, buyers have shown specific behaviors, which I am going to list for you. Firstly, some of the buyers did not know the original reasons for the price rise, and though they could not determine the length of the duration of price rise, so they did not dare to do anything. Secondly, some pesticide traders have an advantage in procurement and sales because they keep a relatively large stock of goods, so they were not in a hurry to purchase and sell their goods. In general, the greater the annual sales of traders, the more goods they will stockpile in China. Since most of the pesticide formulation enterprises also produce pesticide technical, they have a certain number of inventories in the case of short supply. So most formulation enterprises have not necessarily increased the prices of pesticide formulations so far. Thirdly, some of the buyers did not dare to raise prices significantly in order to maintain their own sales, especially for their key customers. Besides, wholesalers offered a slight increase in quotation or even maintained the original quotation to terminal retailers in order to obtain the terminal market competitive advantage. Therefore, the buyers of pesticide technical and wholesalers have to reduce their profits, bearing the impact brought by the price rise of raw materials. In 2018, it is expected that the current wait-and-see attitude will continue along with the environmental supervision even becoming stricter. Market and policy uncertainties will prompt buyers to pay more attention to changes in the industry and develop better procurement strategies. The game atmosphere between suppliers and buyers will definitely be more intense. So what is the influence on Chinese pesticide exports? Pesticide exporters have expressed that there's no obvious advantage in export prices nowadays anymore compared to the past, and the export volume of pesticides has generally decreased correspondingly. Especially in the second half of 2017, export prices of pesticides have risen significantly due to environmental pressure, and they would continue to rise. At the end of last year, pesticide technical and formulations witnessed dropping export volume year on year, but the former had a larger declining range, and they enjoyed climbing export value and export prices. Specifically, the export volume of plant growth regulators increased significantly, but that of insecticides and fungicides showed a relatively large decline. However, the export value of insecticides and fungicides even grew the most. In order to further explore the impact of China's environmental protection policies on the pesticide exports, CCM has selected some export monitoring data in 2016 and 2017 of China's five mainstream pesticide products, namely 2,4-D, glyphosate, acetochlor, chlorpyrifos, and azoxystrobin. The export volume of these five pesticide products did not clearly reflect the impact of environmental protection policies on their exports, which was reflected obviously in the FOB price, however. Specifically, the FOB prices of these five pesticide products showed significant increases in the second half of 2017. This is related to the fact that the Chinese government has strengthened the environmental supervision during that period. And now we come to the influence of the trade war or trade dispute between China and the USA. First, give you a little background. At the end of March, Donald Trump, the president of the USA, officially signed a memorandum on potential tariffs on Chinese goods at the White House, which would impose large-scale tariffs on import from China and restrict Chinese companies from investing in the USA. China's Ministry of Commerce swiftly made a response, planning to impose tariffs on certain products imported from the USA. This marked the beginning of a new round of the iconic Sino-US trade war. As the trade war between China and the USA intensifies, the USA would restrict the development of high-end technologies in China by restricting China's imports of high-tech products, while China restricts the import of agricultural products from the USA as a tough response. It is worth noticing that China and the USA have reached a framework agreement on bilateral trade issues. The probability of a Sino-US trade dispute escalating into a trade war in the short term has therefore dropped significantly. The US Secretary of Treasury even said that China promises to significantly increase imports of US agricultural and energy products, while the USA will step back from imposing tariffs on Chinese exports to the USA. Both sides have not yet implemented any substantial actions on tariff levying. However, the tariff lift issues by the two have aroused great attention from all walks of life, and the agrochemical industry is no exception. CCM believes that the trade war means challenges but also opportunities for China's agrochemical industry. In 2015 to 2017, the US ranked first among all glyphosate export destinations from China. The country is also the major market of Chinese glyphosate. Therefore, as the China-US trade war was heating up, many people getting interested in whether it will bring great impact on the sale of domestic glyphosate enterprises. However, these enterprises said they have no worry about that because although the USA is the largest export destination, the share in total exports is actually small. If we insist that there's a negative impact on glyphosate sales from the trade war, it would be rather be the changing USD-RMB exchange rate. Domestic pesticide formulation business of agrochemical enterprises such as Zhejiang Yunsha and Hubei Sanoda will get benefited if China starts levying tariffs on American products. In the meantime, some will be negatively affected, such as Lear Chemical and Shandong Weifang, because they are the main suppliers of pesticides into the USA. The China-USA trade war spurs agricultural production prices, which is good news actually for the agrochemical market. China is the major agricultural product importer from the USA. On the beginning of April, the Ministry of Commerce announced that it has decided to impose additional tariffs of 25% on agricultural products from USA, including soybean, corn, and sorghum. This was expected to benefit pesticide formulation enterprises. Affected by rising raw material costs or dropping export, the industry reform and layout may be accelerated for the long run. Notably, pesticides with large export amounted to the USA attract attention. So namely are glyphosate, glufosinate ammonium, clethodim, and atrazine. Although these products are not on the tariff list, they will be indirectly affected in a way. In addition, some pesticide raw materials, pesticide formulations, and some insecticides will be levied an additional tariff, which may leave some markets to other products. So it is estimated that the trade war between the USA and China will have certain impact on China's exports of, for example, glyphosate, though the impact will be limited. In 2017, the export volume of China's glufosinate ammonium products to the USA occupied 47% of China's total, which was far more than that to Australia, the second export destination of China's glufosinate ammonium. It's estimated that the Sino-US trade war will therefore have relatively great impact on China's export of glufosinate ammonium products. It's also estimated that the Sino-US trade war's impacts of China's export of pesticide products won't be that large. Being the biggest export destination of China's agrochemical products in 2017, the USA only accounted for a small share of total export volume, followed closely by the second market, Brazil. According to CCM's research, the Sino-US trade war will have a certain impact on China's export of clethodim products. China sold 98 0.08% of its Clethodim products to overseas market. The US hereby was the biggest export destination of China's Clethodim products in 2017, taking up 27.35% of China's total export volume of Clethodim products, and therefore is impacted by the trade dispute. That brings us to the end of this webinar. Thank you all very much for joining. And remember, if you have any questions or further information on the topic, please just write us an email and then we will gather your questions, answer them and give you an email back soon. I hope you get some good ideas about the impacts of environmental protection measurements and the trade war on China's agrochemical market. I highly recommend you to look at the products and newsletters that CCM is providing to be always informed about what's happening in the market. Thank you all again and have a very great day.